not all is bad despite what seems to be a very hard business environment due to COVID-19. The National Social Security Fund announced a 12.15% interest rate for its savers. Hello and welcome to this week's business show. My name is Viola. Let's take a look now at the stories that made headlines in the business world, both locally and internationally. NSSF posts a 400 billion shillings growth in income. Kenya export earnings from Uganda up 57% on tax deal. ShopRite nets $10 million from sale of Uganda, Madagascar and Nigeria units. Global oil price rises above $80 for first time in 3 years.
Embracing technology is one way of making sure that your business stays ahead.
You can go and Google anything you like, you want to do. You can go to Mr. Google and ask.
Once again, welcome to the show. Now, it's no secret that the hospitality industry has been severely hit by COVID-19, with so many employees losing their jobs and hotels recording not even a quarter of their usual bookings. However, investors look at the markets differently. This week, on Views from the Top, we'll look at a Continental hotel that has just opened doors in Uganda.
Quentin Devetz, I'm the general manager here at the Onomo Hotel Kampala, which we officially launched today. I represent two of Onomo's hotels. This is my second property that I've opened up for Onomo. The first one was in Maputo in 2019 in December. And we're excited that we are able to open up in the market in this current environment. As we know, in the hospitality industry, hotels are struggling at the moment, right? The whole industry, not just hospitality, but all sectors. But ours is a special mix of struggle. So coming to the market, we're bringing to the market at the moment where people have been locked up in their homes for almost 2 years, where we can't live normal and we need to adapt to a new normal. And that new normal is what we also want to participate in. We want to bring to the Ugandan market now in this environment, something new, but also something that's going to be here for a long time. We have the confidence in the industry. We as a brand is always expanding. This is hotel number 22 for Onomo Hotel Groups on the continent. So for us to open now is we have this confidence and this belief that the tourism industry, we shouldn't wait for it until the times are better. We should look for the opportunities in the market at the moment. So as we spoke earlier, over the lunch period, is that one door closes and one shouldn't just think that that's the end of things. We need to be resilient. There's many challenges each one of us are facing at the moment. But by bringing the product to the market now, it allows us to establish ourselves and be ready when things start to move. Recently, His Excellency opened up that weddings and functions can move up to 200 people, depending on the capacity of the venue. That was a very good move, and we're very happy that it's starting the restrictions are starting to come apart so that we can trade and we can be there, that place for people to escape their normal life at the moment. And I found that Uganda or Ugandans love something new. And that's clear from just us being now for 2 days, we've been open and people are coming in and they're excited. And we're excited. It gives job opportunities for our local colleagues, well, for all of us. We have about a team of 40 people. That, if you look at the ripple effect, if you look at the ripple effect of all of these furnitures, the companies that we've supported locally with all our great partners, that's all businesses driving from this direct investment coming into the country. This is now our third hotel in East Africa. We have Mozambique, like I mentioned. We have Dar es Salaam Actually, it's the fourth, correction, because we also have Kigali. So the fourth one in East Africa. And for tourism, I believe Uganda has this hidden gem, this hidden pearl, like the Pearl of Africa. It's still hidden. And there's so much opportunity to get more people into tourism here. We all know South Africa. We all have been to Kenya for the safari. Uganda is well known for the gorillas, but there's so much beautiful natural beauty and people to explore. For us, we're a city hotel, but you are going to come here and experience something. We don't want you to just experience a hotel or a restaurant. When you come to an Onomo hotel, it's about the experience and the lifestyle. We partner with artists. We give them a platform, local artists, which may not have a platform in a gallery, to come and showcase themselves. We have music partners that we give a proper opportunity for local artists. So wherever we go, whether we are in Kigali, whether we are in Kampala, or even if we are in Morocco and Casablanca, we partner with that local talent. Because if you keep on developing that local talent and local business, you put back in. And the more you put back in and the more you support local business, the more the economy can grow. Yes, we had to import quite a lot of items building this project. And it's one of our flagship properties for the group. But as much as we had to buy from outside, the first question we asked ourselves, is it available for us locally? And who can manufacture what we wanted? And with the talent, it's very, very clear. If you look at the hotel at the moment, that talent, that pushing back into the economy has been, in my opinion, a really good success. Not many businesses are privileged enough to open their doors in this pandemic. More and more companies are closing rather than opening. So for us to be here, it adds something new exciting. This means that if you're a vegetable supplier, you're a furniture supplier, you're providing me chemicals, these are all businesses that are getting a new source of income, a new way of doing business because there's a new partner. So for you to have a business that can supply goods to the hotel is a good thing. Also in the competition, I always like it when hotels open up or new business in your competitors open, because it puts you back and say, hey, I need to improve my service because there's a new competitor on the street. I don't have the monopoly. So it gradually, we all push each other up, 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 up. And that increased productivity, that increased service levels makes us all deliver a better product, which brings more people, which that third party, that ripple effect of suppliers, they get more business. And that makes, I think, that would make me excited if I had no opportunity of new expansions. And all of a sudden, there's a 148 bedroom hotel that opens up in the city. I would be excited to be one of those clients that would come up, or the supplier to be there. But as a guest, it's a new experience. And we all want something to escape. Every hotel provides you walls, a restaurant chair, a table, food, a bed. But here at Onomo, I was privileged to meet many of our different hotels and be at the different hotels. And what sets us aside is when we enter a market, our people drives that economy, our people drives the brand. And that confidence with the team behind us, that gives us the peace of mind, plus the beautiful asset we have to say, here's the hotel, now drive and make business sense. So for me, with the right team behind you, you can be confident in doing a business. If we fear doing business in any, not even in a hotel, in any field of business, if we're going to fear opening up a business, taking that step and saying, hey, I'm going to do this, then we might as well stay at home and hope the government could support us, which it's difficult in these times. So you need to be bold and take that step and say, I'm going to do it. Because tomorrow there's a credit crunch. The day after that, there's another. So we need to learn how to adapt and move forward in the time and in business. And I think business now has really been thrown upside down. We all had to think, how can I make my business work inside the framework of the restrictions? And companies, I think, have managed that, bringing down the cost of one side, people can't travel, but we need to have people doing their jobs. So embracing technology is one way of making sure that your business stays ahead. I think the important thing and why Onomore is still here today is we adapt to that situation. And from the beginning, before COVID, our most important thing when we enter a market is not to say that we focus on that foreign business that's coming in. That is, we welcome all our guests and we're very happy when we have a good business mix. But if you're not reliant on the support from the local community where you are establishing your business, and you're relying on something that is foreign or far away, anything can disrupt that business. Now, true, a large portion of all our business is impacted by the international traveler. But if you focus, like we did with many of our hotels, on the local market, you can get through this stormy weather and get to the other side. And that's the important thing at this point, I believe, is for us to get through this COVID period, survive and establish. Don't lose the quality. Don't lose the respect from your client. Survive this period. And when it's over, we're going to make good business again. First thing that came to mind, the first time I arrived into the city, was the variety of options available, from the smallest independent-owned hospitality development. I believe what's on the UTB board is what, 4,000 establishments in the country. And I found that fascinating. There's so many, it caters for every person. But there's some form of organicness to many of the establishments, which is, you don't feel like you're just in another hotel or another establishment. Ugandan people, the Ugandan market, I felt like, apart from the fact that there was clients missing, because it was empty, the quality of the product and the variety, everything is not the same. There's variety in the market. Just a couple of hours of drive, you're in Jinja at the source of the Nile, and you can experience there far more adventurous and outdoors style. Then another 3 hours in another direction, and you have beautiful waterfalls and natural beauty. So for me, this is like a hidden gem. There's so much opportunity for tourism to grow, and that ripple effect of what it contributes to the communities where it establishes. And again, if we embrace more the technology, the online presence, we can boost the awareness of Uganda. When I came here, one of my neighbors said, oh, you're going to the bird paradise of Africa. And nowhere, I thought, yeah, there will be birds. Even here in a city hotel, I have the most beautiful hornbills. And I don't know what the other bird was. And you have the marabou storks. I always watch because they're dangerous and they're flying over your head. But I look at them and it's true. You don't feel like you're in a city with just concrete. There's so much interaction between nature and humans with what we're building. I think that makes it still a desired aspect. You're not just lost in concrete, and you kept that. And the city is clean. That is one of the best things I've noticed when I drove in. I believe KCCA, in the drive of keeping Kampala as one of the cleanest cities, they're really succeeding. And that I can say, well done. It even inspires me when I walk. I always try and pick up something, but it stands out, a plastic bottle on the side of the road. You want to pick it up because it is such a clean environment. And with all of that, from the authorities to the private sector, working together to create this good business environment, why can we fail?
Surely, it's said that for one to make profit, you must take a risk. But we insist it must be a calculated risk. Otherwise, we wish the new hotel success and hope it breaks through. You're still watching The Business Show. Time now for a quick break.